name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You know, this thing's going through yesterday this morning, and I thought I was going to be back so we can get downstairs and hear what the food we got in here. Our lesson today begins with the reading from the law by Ezra. The setting is in Jerusalem, soon after the Jews have been released from Babylonian exile. Nehemiah had been sent to Judah as the governor. And soon after his arrival, he instructed the priest Ezra to read aloud the law of the Lord to inform the people as how they should live and follow the laws of God as set down in the book of Leviticus. The people realized their sin and made the covenant as directed by Nehemiah. Now they had been weeping. So Nehemiah says, don't weep. This is a good law. This is the way the Lord wants us to live. So let's eat, drink, and be merry. And that's exactly what they did. Now fast forward 500 years. The lengthening shadows of Friday's sun are closing upon the town of Nazareth and the hill country of Galilee. The blast of the shofar, which is the ram's horn, proclaimed the beginning of the Sabbath, as they call it, the Shabbat. The following morning, Jesus went to the synagogue, as was his practice since he was a child. And no doubt the news of the miracle at the wedding of Cana in Galilee, and also the one in Jordan where the heavens proclaimed his divinity, had preceded him. And people were excited to hear what the hometown girl might have to say. So in the synagogue, Jesus is called forward and is handed the scroll of Isaiah. And the portion that he chose to read dealt with the suffering servant of God. And we quote from Luke 4, 18 to 19. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me. He has sent me to pronounce good news to the poor, to proclaim the release of prisoners and recovery of sight of blind, and to let the broken victims go free. Proclaim the year of the Lord. This passage was very familiar to our Jewish friends. It was an Old Testament prophecy concerning the release of Jews from Babylonian captivity. But Jesus did something unusual, as he always does. He took this text woven out of the exile and wrapped it around himself. He changed the meaning of the poor, the enslaved, the blind. The poor were those who had no grace and lacked a union with God. The blind were those who had not yet seen the light of God. And the enslaved were those who had not yet purchased true freedom from sin. He then proclaimed that all of these things were centered in himself. The scripture was fulfilled in Jesus and would be fulfilled in him as he continued his ministry. The Spirit was leading him to the cross for the restoration and reconciliation of the world. Do you see what's happened? The work of anointed service begun by Jesus as he fulfilled the scriptures proclaimed that day in the synagogue was carried on by those in ministry who likewise reached out in ministry to others. It's still being fulfilled today. In Paul's letter to the Corinthians, his problem child in the churches, he spoke, and we put the lesson way back today, but he spoke about the body and the parts of the body, the eye, the ear, the nose, the feet, the hands, the heart. Not one of those things is more important than the other. And what he's also saying is that We are all the body of Christ. And what's the body of Christ make up?
The church.
The church. And that's what we are. We are the church. Every one of us is different. The hand can't do what the feet do, but they can't get along without each other. We can't do what we do unless we work together. And this is what Paul is trying to tell the church of Christ. They're anointed. And we too have been anointed by the Spirit of the Lord to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, to recover sight to the blind, to heal people, to set free those who are oppressed. We've been anointed by our baptism into the incarnate Christ. We have to announce that God's day is today, this very day. That now is the acceptable time, and now is the day of salvation. As we mull over these words and think about them, the thought in our minds, listen to the words of St. Teresa of Avila. Christ has no body on earth but ours. No hands, no feet on earth but ours. Yours, ours, are the eyes through which Christ looks compassionately into the world. Ours are the feet with which Christ walks to do good. And ours are the hands with which Christ blesses the world. Anointed by God, baptized into the death and the resurrection of Christ, and therefore his body, the body of the church, we are involved in the comforting, liberating, redeeming, uplifting, and lightening salvation that Christ accomplished in his body for us. And so also involved in the messianic ministry of Christ that wants to accomplish through his body today. And his body today is us, the church. In the power of the Holy Spirit, the scripture is still being fulfilled.